Yes, hello YouTube. I've got this the both batteries removed from this Craftsman battery pack, the two that I determined were dead, and then I've got my two new cells that I picked up last week, and I've got both these charged up, and I charged up the other three in there, and what I've done is cleaned up the tabs here, got them straightened out after breaking the spot welds kind of deforms them, so I got those flattened out as best I could and kind of bent them up so they're kind of sprung into the battery, and that way then I can put the new cells in and they kind of hold the tabs down to the terminals on the battery. And just this one here, this is the main negative. You come down positive, and then that hooks to the negative of this cell up to positive. And then this last cell is going to go in negative on the top, positive, and then over to this one, negative to positive, and then negative to positive. And this is your essentially the 18, 19 volts. Positive, and then this is your negative, so you just got to make sure you get the cells in there properly, so all of these terminals, the bridging terminals, take the positive to the next negative, and this one here was the positive to this negative, so you just have to make sure you get all those all the battery alignments straight, and then you can give it a go with the soldering iron. So I'll come back and show you what that looks like. Okay, I'll see if I can do this without blocking the camera. So what I've found that works pretty good is you need, I've tinned the end of the battery terminal with a little bit of flux and some solder just to get that, and then I've tinned the bottom side of the terminal on the battery. And then what seems to work is if you need the soldering iron, get that on the, wait till that melts. And then kind of hold it down while the solder cools, because it's going to want to spring up a little bit. And just repeat that for all four connections, or two for each battery at least. So I'll let that cool and then flip the battery over, and I got to solder the other two sides, and then it's time to check it out, see if we get around 20 volts across the terminals. So I'll be back when I get that finished. Oh, and one other tip I found, or a little pointer, is to make sure that because the batteries kind of want to spring out of the case a little bit, so you want to get them pushed in as far as you can prior to soldering them in place, because once they're soldered in place, and if they're sticking out a little bit, the bottom of the case may not fit on, so you can see this one wants to pop out just a little bit, so kind of make sure that they're all the way in before you heat up the solder and get them stuck in place. So I'll come back when I have the rest of them soldered in and we can check it out. And one tip I found was also I have a temperature controlled HECO 936 soldering station, and I had it pretty much turned it up. I think, let's see what the number is over there. I was up around 450 C, so I had it turned up. I normally run it around maybe 300, 350 or so is where I usually use it. So I turned it, turned it up about as high as it would go. And then when you're soldering, I'll swing back over to the batteries here. So like I said, when you're soldering the tabs, you want the heat really high, so you heat this up quickly, and I found that it actually works better I have a magnifier that I put over, and heat just until you see the solder, the tinning that you put on the terminal of the battery, just until that liquefies, and then pull the iron away. But you have to leave something on there to keep the terminal or the little tab pressed down until the solder cools, because you've heated up quite a bit of metal there. So it takes maybe 10 seconds. You've got to hold it in place, or otherwise you'll get a cold solder joint there. So you want to heat it really hot, really fast, and then have something metal there to hold it down while the solder solidifies. And that seemed to work pretty good. Let's put this back together and see what kind of voltage we get. Okay, I have everything put back together. It's a kind of tight fit. You got to get the batteries shoved back in the case, get the if you have the fuel gauge, get that plugged back in. This was the one that was actually, it looks like I have a broken one of the wires, didn't like being bent, so I'm gonna have to solder that back in. I imagine the green LED probably doesn't light up anymore. In fact, I can check that. Oh yeah, so that circuit board, I've got to take that back apart and check that fuel gauge. I must have knocked it loose, but let's check the batteries. So here we go, 20.6 volts. That sounds like 5 times 4.1 and a little bit, so that sounds good. I'll check the fuel gauge here and see what's going on with that. This is one of the early fuel gauges, so it's, I didn't unscrew anything, but it looks like it jiggled its way loose there, so I'll have to check that out. So let's see what's going on with that.